Hello and welcome everyone, XDA Dante 63 here. I'm once again updating the tutorial video to explain how to connect your Wear OS watch to your phone and sideload the SHM mod using the new method wireless debugging. Let's start with what is happening. Google removed debug over Wi-Fi. There are claims that it's not secure because port number is fixed. And no answers were given in regards how it could be a risk when the user has to allow the incoming connection first and not responding with revoke it and its feature requests. Not to mention, the user can turn off debug over Wi-Fi if the watch is receiving many requests. Let's say a script is generating different requests and trying to ADB connect. Google simply removed it and left us with debug over Bluetooth and wireless debugging options. Debug over Bluetooth is good if you don't have Wi-Fi network and it's done through the PC. You connect your phone to the PC via USB with USB debugging on, and your watch is Bluetooth connected to your phone with debug over Bluetooth on. With few ADB commands on your PC, your phone becomes a bridge connecting your PC to your watch. But keep in mind, Bluetooth has poor transfer capabilities. So wireless debugging is the new way, and I'll be explaining it to you guys. First, let's start by downloading SHM Mod Companion. I have put in the description three links: Google Drive, Telegram, and XDA Form. So I'm gonna go ahead and download from XDA, but you can choose whatever you like. So I open the link. I download. I'm gonna close this. Wait for the download to complete. Download is complete, so I just tap on that and install SHM Mod Companion. SHM Mod Companion is a tool I'm constantly updating to improve it, and it's a tool that allows you to stay up to date with SHM Mod, and it helps you easily set up everything related to SHM Mod. Right, let me just close this. I'm going to open SHM Mod Companion. In here you can set your update, check for updates. And now we're going to download SHM Wear OS Mod version. Okay, so we're just going to tap once, tap again, and then you can go ahead and hit download. So I hit install, package installer. I have to allow and unknown source. So install again. There we go. Now I'm going to open SHM Mod Wear OS. Accept. We will skip this. So let me just enter the details. And cancel for this. Now we are almost set. So phone side is done. Now we're going to go for the watch side. So we are going to go to the watch section. Now there is a help section. If you ever forget, you can always go through this. We're going to go through this together now. Let me turn on the camera. Okay, camera is on. So I'm going to hold my watch and I'm going to go to settings. I'm gonna scroll the way down, about watch, scroll a bit more down, software information, software version, tap on it, developer mode is turned on. So we go back to settings, developer options. We're gonna open this, we're gonna scroll down. For the sake of handling all cases of the Wear OS watch, we're going to turn on ADB debug. Because sometimes ADB debug is connected to wireless debugging. And then I am going to turn on hotspot of my phone. And I'm going to exit wireless debugging because I have to go to connection first and select the Wi-Fi I want to connect to wireless debugging. So Wi-Fi, I need to make sure that my watch connected to the phone hotspot. And as you can see, it's connected. You can select a different network, but your phone has to be connected to the same network of your watch. But if you want a smooth connection and stable, I recommend that you connect your watch network to your phone. So now that I have done this, go back to developer options and back to wireless debugging. can tap several times until it gets connected. ITDev, this is my hotspot, my phone. Always allow this network. Allow. The first thing I'm gonna do is pair new device. Okay, so I'm gonna go on SHMod Companion. I'm gonna go ahead with the pair. I have everything set correctly. Now I just have to enter the port 44169. And now the pairing code 128083. Pair the device. Now if you would notice, it's going to ping, and once it's success, it automatically exits from the pairing. Now I can connect directly, so I'm just going to go ahead. It says in here, and there you have it. Wireless debugging, notification, and you're connected. If you can't connect, you can go ahead on your watch. You can revoke debugging authorization and then repeat. You're going to pair your watch again if it does not connect. But most of the time, it will connect immediately. And you can pair as much as you want. It doesn't really affect anything. You can pair as much as you want. Right. Now we're going to download the Watch SHM mod. So download. Notice that when you download these APKs, there is no install because these are your watch application. Now I'm going to download also the Watch SHM mod companion. This is just to show you that you can check for updates. Okay, so I'm going to go back and back. I'm going to open this. Now I'm going to say select APK, so dismiss, select APK. It's going to be in your download folder and then SHM mod companion. You're going to select watch. It has to have watch in its name. So this is the watch SHM. So I'm sideloading the watch SHM mod and I should see the icon created right over here. There it is. So if I open my phone SHM mod, you can see that now I can calibrate. Now I would recommend you that you remove the original if you find yourself getting a mixing up between those. So if you remove it, as you can see, it will immediately disappear. And if you want to restore it, you can just tap on the restore and it will restore it. So I'm going to sideload the last thing, the companion for the watch. And I will explain to you what is the use of the companion for the watch. As you can see, so I'm going to disconnect. I am going to turn off the ADB. I can check for updates. The watch app will send the response. And I will see right over here. It says you have the latest version installed. You have the latest version installed. This is the main feature for having the watch app. Next, so that's it, we're done from the watch. You can just go ahead and calibrate and do everything you want. Now let's say that your watch or your phone is unable to detect your watch. So as long your watch can actually, let's just go ahead, I'm going to open the mod, allow. So let's say I am getting on the phone, I can't see my watch. If I say open phone app, so let me just close this. I say open phone app. Then there is a connection. I just have to restart the watch and restart the phone and it will work. Okay. Another way to shake and nudge is to actually go in here, settings, and just open accessories. Wait for this to load and refresh. Okay. Don't add or do anything. It should automatically detect your watch. Now we're done from the camera. Let me just turn off the camera. There we go. Okay. Now, last few steps in the SHM mod companion, we're going to go into BP Sync. We're going to tap on this. This will create a folder called Samsung Health and create a feature manager on file inside it. It will be inside your downloads. Okay. Once you do this, you can follow the instructions right over here. Now pay attention. A lot of people have messaged me saying that they keep tapping on the version, but nothing happened. I want you to focus that it's Samsung Health, not Samsung Health Monitor. Okay, Samsung Health Monitor has almost the same identical interface, but the name is Samsung Health Monitor. If you tap on the version here, nothing will happen. Okay, so with that being said, let me take you through this. So I'm gonna open Samsung Health. I'm gonna go to settings, scroll all the way down, about Samsung Health, tap on the version number, you'll see set features again. Health Analytics, set it to Dev, Data Platform, scroll down, and turn on Developer Mode. Once you're done, you're gonna go hit back, you're going to see this, you're gonna hit OK, Force Stop, and Storage, Clear Cache. Once you're done, now you can go back to SHM Mod, and then you're gonna go Settings, Data Permissions, Samsung Health. Now you should be able to trigger this and toggle it. Hit done. Now your BP data will sync to your Samsung Health. But keep in mind, if you want to trigger the sync, you have to measure a new BP. With that being said, what else is left? Okay guys, so the last part is, what about ECG? The ECG does not sync to Samsung Health, but there is something called ECG tile in Samsung Health. How do you get this? You can install the ECG tile link. So I'm just gonna hit this and install it. And I'm just gonna show you guys that I don't have it. So let me just hit on edit home. I'm gonna add, there is nothing. So I'm gonna go right over here. This is the ECG. So I'm gonna say show ECG in Samsung Health. Let me go back. And there it is. ECG data from Samsung Health. As long as you have this application, this tile will always be there. And if you click on it, it will open for you Samsung Health Mod in the ECG tab. And that's pretty much it. After that, I recommend you to read the frequently asked questions, read about the features. You can read about the permissions if you guys have interest, what this companion has permissions and why. You can read all this right over here. I usually post bugs, but there are no bugs now. And what's new, I always push a change log for everything I have updated. And that's pretty much it, guys. You can always reach me from the home. You can always reach me through any of the social media or any of these links. You can support me, and your support is highly appreciated through PayPal or Patreon or through installing other apps I have developed in app purchase. And guys, if you find that this is really easy to use to connect and sideload, then you should check out GeminiMan Wear OS Manager. It's an ADB tool with so much in it, such as backup, debloat, and everything. You will love this application. And since, if you've noticed, it has almost identical interface, you have also Logcat and everything, it's really nice tool. There are no ads, and I'm always updating it to improve it. So I hope you like this. And I always develop watch faces and apps and all. You can install this to see everything I have developed. And I would appreciate if you guys would leave me a review on the Play Store. Your reviews will boost the visibility of the application on Play Store. Thank you very much guys for watching. I hope this video is straightforward, productive, and very helpful. If you guys need any help, reach me out and I'll do my best to help. Have a great day.